Remember when you were a kid and you got a new toy? It was shiny and new, and nothing in the world could make you happier. For a few days, it was the center of your world until the novelty wore off. Then you wanted a new one. The same happens to technologies. When technology is young and new, it seems like the best thing since sliced bread. For a few months, or maybe years, everybody loves it. Books are written about it, conferences organized, experts baptized, until the novelty wears off. Then it's forgotten, or in the best case, used in some obscure niches. I mean, who uses satellite phones anymore? But some toys are different, like Lego bricks. They enable kids and grown-ups to be creative, to make new things over and over again. Novelty is just one small piece of their value. Lego bricks are a transformative technology. They transform people from consumers to creators and make them proud along the way. Toys like this are always shiny and new. Some technologies are also different. They change the way we live our lives, learn, communicate, buy, and sell. These technologies transform users and businesses, becoming a new standard. And when technology is becoming a new standard, you want to be an early adopter. Applications of augmented reality in business, especially retail, are still recent. However, some companies are making huge money using it. Let's see a few examples. IKEA Place App. Launched in 2017, IKEA Place App is one of the most successful applications of augmented reality in retail. Like all magical technologies, it looks so simple and obvious. Of course you want to try the furniture before you buy it. And you want to try it in your home to see how it fits. IKEA surveyed customers and determined that 35% of them returned the furniture product because they didn't like how it looked in their home. That's a lot of unnecessary expenses and bad feelings for customers and the company. With Place App, both sides win. IKEA has reduced the cost of returns and buyers can try more than 3,200 IKEA products before purchase, not just to see the product, to actually see how it looks in their living or working space. Try to replicate that kind of experience without AR. And it paid off handsomely for IKEA. Digital sales, which now constitute about 10% of total revenue, increased by 50% in 2019. Since IKEA's annual revenue is around $45 billion, they sell more through digital channels than most competitors do in total. Consumers, current and potential, like the digital experience and made more than 2.3 billion visits to IKEA's website in 2017 only. IKEA, the master of simple, is embracing AR to make their user experience as compelling and as simple as possible. And the users are loving it. Artistry Virtual Beauty. Cosmetics is a tough business. While the market is increasing, so is the number of players competing. It has never been easier to launch your own skincare and beauty product lines with production outsourced to Asia, a continent with a lifelong history of skincare production and use. Most of the big players like Estee Lauder, L'Oreal, Lancôme Paris, and Maybelline have had their big marketing budgets spent on advanced technological solutions in digital retail. But due to the democratic nature of digital technologies, smaller players joined the race. Amway, a multi-level marketing company that sells mostly health and beauty products, has turned to AR in order to improve its 2017 decreasing sales. Artistry Cosmetics, one of Amway's product lines, got a new AR experience app, enabling users to try on makeup products before buying. The app was a success, with more than 600,000 users in 53 markets. Financially, Amway recovered in 2018, selling 8.8 billion of merchandise. More than 70% of orders in China, a huge market for Amway, were made through digital channels. Virtual beauty app alone made 1 million plus of revenue in 2018. Smaller companies cannot match the budgets of big players, but can and will match creativity and technical abilities. Chrono 24. Social climate, gender roles, and perception of femininity and masculinity are radically changing, affecting the skincare industry more and more. While the skincare and beauty industry that was traditionally dominated by female customers is seeing significant changes in consumer demographics, the luxury watch industry has been and remained a male playing field for decades, if not centuries. And men also want their augmented reality retail apps. Chrono 24 got them one for watches. Chrono 24 is a marketplace for new and used luxury watches. An innovative company in a competitive market turned to augmented reality to make a top-notch customer experience. A new app was born in 2018. Chrono 24 app allows customers, both female and male, to see how the watch looks on the hand before purchase. Luxury watches are expensive, often seen as an investment, making a decision about buying one a complicated mental and emotional exercise. Seeing one on your hand helps you decide. As author Michelle Janay said, "If beauty is in the eye of the beholder, value is in the eye of the customer. Your product and experience should appeal both to customers' emotional and rational parts. AR can help you, shining a light on product's beauty and quality." Chrono 24 is pretty successful. More than 500,000 listings accessible through the app, with 20,000 verified sellers and dealers. Users from 100 countries are using the app. Almost 40,000 reviews on App Store suggest that downloads are in the higher hundreds of thousands. As we said before, magical technologies are simple and obvious. If retail is your industry, you might ask yourself, why didn't I think of that before? AR is not an exotic, nerdy, sci-fi thing anymore. There's a lot of money to be made using augmented reality. It will become the standard in user experience soon, dividing companies into two groups: companies that use AR and companies that don't exist anymore. Let our AR experts help you make a future-ready experience for your customers.